Almighty and ever-living God, whose will it is that the earth and sea should bear fruit in due season, bless the labors of all those who work on land and sea. Grant us a good harvest and the grace always to rejoice in your care. In the name of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us proceed.
The Lord be with you. Please follow the monitor for the first part of the service. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Creating God, you know us better than we know ourselves. We cannot keep secrets from you. You know the dark places of our hearts, where we try to hide that which we do not want you to see. Purify these dark places so that we may love you as you we should. This we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
We are sinful creatures. We cannot deny it or hide it from you. But we confess our sins to our God who created us. And God, who longs for us to be whole, will forgive us our sins and purify our hearts. Let us spend a few moments in silence as we confess our sins to God, known and unknown. Let us confess our sins. We confess to you, creating God, we have sinned against you in our actions and do not glorify. forgive us so that we may live in wholeness. Amen. Jesus Christ was given to die for the sins of all people, once for all things. Because of his suffering, death, and resurrection, God accounts to us Christ's righteousness. We are forgiven and free to live in wholeness by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Our opening hymn this morning is hymn 663, For the Beauty of the Earth, For the Beauty of the Skies. Hymn 663.
The grace of our redeeming Lord Jesus Christ, the creating love of God, and the communion of the sanctified Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
O Creator God, with your breath you created light and darkness. By your word you created the heavens. You created the dry land of the earth and the waters of the sea. By your word, you call forth growing things, plants, fruit trees. You created the sun and the moon to order the day and the nights. You creating the living creatures in the waters and the living creatures of the earth. You created the living creatures of the land, cattle and wild animals, everything that moves upon the land. By your word, you created humankind, both male and female, to care for the earth and all that is over, on, and in it. And to these new creatures, you gave everything that you had made. The colic for Rogation Sunday. The Lord be with you. Let us pray together. O Lord, from whom all the good things do come, your humble servants, that by thy holy inspiration we may think those things that be good, and by thy merciful guiding may perform the same, through Jesus Christ. Amen. Now we thank God for the creation, ask God to help us to be good stewards together. O merciful Creator, by the land of every creation, make us, we beseech thee, ever thankful for thy loving providence, and grant that we, as they gave, may be faithful stewards of the good gifts through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please sit for the reading.
Good morning to the church. A reading from the Word of God written in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, beginning at verse 1. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sue, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time for war and a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
The psalm appointed for this service is Psalm 104, verses 24 to 35. Psalm 104.
Thank you.
A reading from the 1 John chapter 5, verses 1 to 6. Everyone who believes that Jesus is Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this, we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome. For whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world? But the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ, not with water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth. Here ends the reading.
The gradual hymn, hymn 529, Lord, the light of your love is shining, in the midst of the darkness shining. Hymn 529.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commandments so that you may love one another. This is the gospel of Christ. In the name of God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Words from the psalm for today. O Lord, how manifold are your words. Today is a special day in the life of the church as we celebrate Rogation Sunday. Now, there's a difference between Rogation Sunday and the Harvest Thanksgiving. The two are not the same. On Rogation Sunday, we ask God to bless the land. What before, the blessing was restricted to agriculture because, you know, years ago, that was what kept the economies going, but nowadays we have industry and commerce. So today we ask God to bless our land, agriculture, industry, commerce, and manufacturing. But at the harvest, we thank God for the fruit, whatever the land has produced, whatever we get from industry and commerce. So Rogation, we ask God to bless the land, and the harvest, we thank God for the fruits and all that have come. And this morning, we join with Christians throughout the world, especially our brothers and sisters in the Anglican Church, to ask God to bless our nation, Barbados. And this morning, we are praying for agriculture and farmers, industry, commerce, construction. Today, we pray for our fishermen and ask God to bless the sea. In essence, we are asking God to bless every aspect of life in Barbados and to bless us and to give us prosperity. And at the same time, as we ask God to bless our land and to give us prosperity, we recognize our dependence on God for our sustenance. Sometimes we live as though we are the ones who made life possible, and we forget God. But as Christians, we recognize that all gifts we have, whatever there is in the creation, it comes from Almighty God. We are all different. We have animals, the trees, human beings. But all of us, you know, human beings and the animals, all of us are integral parts of God's creation. We too are creatures. We are not the creator, and we are called to worship God, who is the creator, and not to worship the creature. And today we are reminded that all creatures are made by the loving God, that all of us are blessed by God. But the difference is, human beings have been given the responsibility to care for the universe. So we have a responsibility to care for the environment, to care for the world in which we live, and to be good stewards of God's creation. And so St. Paul says in the Acts of the Apostles, I guess you might know the text, in him we live and what? And move and have our being. In him we live and move and have our being. What part is in that? Look, we are totally dependent on God for our life and our existence. But some of you may ask this morning, what do the resurrection and forgiveness and love have to do with Rogation Day? If we are asking God to bless the land, what part resurrection and forgiveness and love have to play on this day? The answer is simple: everything. Resurrection and forgiveness and loving our neighbors as we love ourselves, it has to do with the present situation in which we live. Today, we ask God for his blessings and guidance as we plant, as we prepare the ground, as we produce products, expand our industrial and manufacturing endeavors, as we deal with climate change. What are we doing? We are asking God for an authentic life, which responds to the needs of our citizens. So we're not asking God to bless our land, to bless our lives for selfish persons, reasons, but we are asking God to bless us and bless our land so that we can respond to the needs of humankind. And at this time, friends, we live in a world of agony, a world that is hurting. We are part of that world. So as we ask God and pray for blessing on our land, what are we doing? We are asking God to heal the brokenness that is present in the world and our nation. We pray for God's blessing so that we'll be able to heal the brokenness that is present in the world and in our nation, Barbados. You see, we as a nation, we are hurting because we have made bad choices that place our environment, our economy, our institutions, and all sectors of the nation under tremendous stress. We are consumed by materialism and consumerism. And we place excessive stress on the nation. And what happens is that we try to produce and consume at a rate that is not sustainable, not only in Barbados, but throughout the world. The way that we are consuming, it cannot be sustained. At some time, it is going to collapse, and we are all going to suffer the results when the collapse comes. You see, man has always bowed down to materialism, and in the process, we become slaves of it. And so we consume. Do we need so many paper towels that we have in our kitchens? Do we need that unlimited consumption of so many foods? Do we need the many colognes and perfumes that we buy every month? And for men and women, do we need the many shoes that we buy every month? You know, some people buy a new pair of shoes every month. Huh? And so the question is, do we need this excessive consumption in our lives? The answer is no. And so, Rogation Day for this year, as we speak about love, is a challenge to all of us to live responsible lives and to avoid the unnecessary consumption that is not good for the nation nor for individuals in our lives. Secondly, within the context of blessing and healing, Christians are people who have experienced the life-changing forgiveness of God. And we experience God's forgiveness over and over every day in our lives. But because we have experienced the forgiveness of God in our lives, all of us are obligated to offer forgiveness to all people and to love them. So vocation, as we speak about God's love and blessing, we are reminded that we have a responsibility to forgive and to love all the people of God. So I think this is the key. We cannot receive God's blessings if we do not forgive and love. We cannot receive God's blessings if we do not forgive and love. And the way of life we are called to live is in the baptism, letting the power of God come into our lives. Let the new life of the resurrection break into life in our nation, even at this time. But I also believe that our nation is going through agony and pain because we who claim to be the people of God, we who call ourselves Christians, we have failed to be the lights and the salt of the earth. We have failed. And because we have failed in our lives to reflect the image of God, we contribute to some of the agony which our nation is not going through. You see, because so many of us, we have not shown or demonstrated the power of forgiveness and love. And you can't be a Christian. Now, let me put it differently. You can't be, you know, you might say somebody is a true Christian, you know, but you cannot be a real Christian unless you love and forgive. And so in asking God to bless our land and to give us prosperity, the blessing we seek for Barbados is for the common good. This morning, we do not pray and ask God for blessings on the land or on our lives for selfish reasons. Whatever blessings come to our land are for the common good. We must share whatever we have wherever there is human need. There is no place for greed and selfishness in our Barbadian society. The common good should always be paramount. The blessings we have, we must always share them, and we must share our lives wherever there's a need. Tina Turner asked the question, what's love got to do with it? We were asked the same question this morning, what love has to do with it, but in a different context. In a different context. Read it in. The readings for today focus on love. The epistle from 1 John and the gospel about love. And Jesus said, this is my commandment, that what? that you love one another as well as I have loved you. You see, love is essential for good relationships. Without love, there can be no blessings. And without love, our institutions, our families, our communities, social groups, and the like, we continue to experience strife, dissension, division, and chaos. You know, if everybody in Barbados practiced true love, it'd be a place of peace, you know. No fighting, nobody would be shot, nobody would be raped, nobody would be murdered. And so love is essential if we are to receive the blessings of Almighty God. And when we love, we are able to bring healing to the brokenness in the nation and in our lives and our homes, wherever we are. So what I'm saying this morning, we can only experience healing as a nation, in our church, in our homes, in our families. We can only be healed when we love. And without love, our nation will remain broken and divided. And secondly, love is sacrificial. No one has greater love than this, that what? A man lays down his life for his friends. And he said, and you are my friends. So a part of love is to sacrifice your time and your energies for the benefit of humankind. Love is sacrificial. And if we want to truly love, we have to be prepared to make sacrifices so that persons will benefit from our love. This morning, I really want to suggest that the Precious Touch Foundation, whose members are with us this morning, is love in action. Love in action. Through its word of love, this group brings joy, happiness, hope, peace, and comfort to families who are going through various crises as they try to cope with the challenge of providing and caring for young ones who need special care and a special understanding. I think the Precious Touch Foundation becomes the face of Jesus Christ as they ask this question to boys and girls who are not well. What would you like? What would you like? And in response to this question, this group endeavors to do all that is humanly possible to meet the wishes of the boys and girls to whom they ask the question, what would you like? And so this foundation and all the other groups in our nation that respond to the needs of suffering humanity are engaged in a service of love, which at times can be very costly. And so, We thank God for this group and all the other groups in our nation that are willing to make sacrifices to make life a pleasant experience for persons who have various needs. And so, the only way that we can bring God's blessings to our land, the only way that we can respond to human need and suffering is to make a commitment that we will be God's agents of love in Barbados. And as Bob Marley says, one love. In the name of God, Father, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
We believe in one God, all salvation. He came down from heaven. He suffered. You may need or seek for the prayers.
The response after each petition is, we are your stewards. Let us pray to God who has created us and all that exists in this world, saying, creating God. We pray for those people in the world who go hungry every day, for the children who have not known the taste of bread, creating God. We pray for those people in our community who do not have enough to eat, for the ones who are not able to eat nutritionally balanced meals, creating God. We pray for the governments around the world that they make good and wise decisions regarding food for their peoples, creating God. We pray for the ones who will soon begin to till, plant, and care for the land, so that there will be enough for all to eat, creating God. God, you call us to exercise good stewardship over the land. You call us to care for the land with love and compassion. Help us to answer your call. Help us to tend the land in ways that will make it last, to grow crops that do not damage the land, to engage in sustainable agriculture, creating God. Giver of good gifts, We give you thanks that we are able to come before you with our petitions. We ask for your good favor in response to each of these in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us all to pray.
Please stand. The peace of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all. We shall share the peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Bind. The family of God, we are the promised divine, we are His chosen desire, we bind us together, Lord, bind us together.
seat. Nice to see you at Mass this morning, Rogation Sunday, a special day in the life of the church and the parish. And we hope that God will bless our land and all its people. I go through the notices briefly. Thursday is Ascension Day. Thursday is the feast of the Ascension Day. If you go to page 4 of your parish letter, let me explain something. Page 4 of the parish letter. I think we have enough parish letters, everybody should be able to get one. Now, beginning Wednesday, we're going to have Bible study with St. Mary and St. Matthew at 6 o'clock, beginning Wednesday. And on page 4, it has the Zoom information. So on page 4, you will see the information for the Zoom Bible study. So take note of it and join us on Wednesday at 6 o'clock. Even the grandparents, if you ask your grandsons or daughters to put you on Zoom on their phone, they will be able to follow. So nobody has any excuse, and everybody has at least one cell phone. Some people have 2, 3, and 4. So even the grandparents, you can ask your young ones to put you on Zoom. And keep this for the Zoom information. Now, on Thursday at 4, we have confirmation class. All those who want to be confirmed, and non-confirmation is a commitment, meet me here on Thursday at 4 o'clock. All those who would like to be confirmed, meet me on Thursday at 4 o'clock. I may have to push it back to our past 4, I'm not sure, but this week we will meet at 4 o'clock. As part of our Rogation celebration, in the cross high there are some boxes with ceilings which we have bought. We bought them yesterday, and we are going to distribute them this morning. We have some envelopes which we will give out during the last hymn, and then you are invited to come and take 6 of what you want. I suspect we're going to have some extras, so what I want you to do, take the 6 and stand back, as we say. And then after everybody has received, then come and take some more. Is that clear? There are white envelopes at the back. We invite each person to take 6 of anything. And then what are left over, you can come and get some more. Mia, you have the So is that clear? After the Right, so there are big envelopes which you will be able to take one and put the plants in them also. So is that clear to everybody? And what we want you to do is, as the extension officer said yesterday, last Sunday, keep them for 2 days and wet them so that we get stronger in the sun, and try to plant them on Wednesday. Try to plant them on Wednesday. And we ask you that the first crop
to give away some of it. Whatever comes up first, give away. Now, let me explain to you also, on the box, there's something called, they have Chinese cabbage. They have something called sardine, you know it? And Streichard. Now, they are all cousins. And when they mature, do not put them up. Just cut off the leaves, and they keep bearing again. The Chinese cabbage, I plan to put out the names on the monitor. The Chinese cabbage, the sardine, and Streichard. But you will see the names on the box. And when they grow, don't put them up. Just cut off the leaves, and you can get the leaves for about another year or two. I have some Streichard now for the last 2 years, and they just keep putting on fresh leaves all the time. Also, I suspect our guests may be able to give you two also. Also, I think we should have enough to give to everybody also. Now, Pentecost Sunday, the Feast of Pentecost. After Mass on Pentecost, we are going to have a coffee morning. Coffee morning. It is free. Now, we have given out, everybody has a phone that was given out. Joan, everybody got? Where's Joan? You have more left back? If anybody wants one, raise your hand. Anybody that didn't get one of the slips this morning? Joan, come and give to those who raise their hand, Joan. Come. If you didn't get a slip this morning, Pat has. Anybody who didn't get a slip and you raise your hand? Right. And on this slip, in order to make proper plans and preparations, we ask you to indicate if you are coming. No, not if you are coming. You are coming to Mass. But we ask you to indicate if you are going to remain after Mass for the coffee. And then on the slip, it has some of the items that we are going to share. And we ask you to indicate which ones you like and which ones you do not like. You don't have to put your name on the paper. But so before you leave Mass this morning, ask somebody to help you with a pen or pencil and complete that slip this morning. You all got? But complete the slip this morning before you go and give it to Miss Bruce or to Marvel. Now, the visitors, you all are invited to come to Mass. So you can get a slip after Mass and indicate if we will come to Mass and if we will share in our fellowship. So we also invite the visitors after Mass. Don't forget to get one also. The flowers are given by Iris and Ronald. This is the third anniversary of their son's death. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. Birthday greetings. Birthdays. We extend birthday greetings to Shady Carrington. Jean Whitehead. Is Jean at church? Yes, Jean is at church. Darius Tudor, not at church. Darius. Drake Tudor, Drake. Annette Beckers. Annette is sitting there. Marcina Williams. No. Geraldine Brown is Geraldine at church? No, it's not at Mass. Tanisha Brian. Tanisha is sitting on my right. Is she at Mars? Tanisha is at church? Yes. And Lisa Lynch. Lisa Lynch. Is she at Mars? Yeah, they're at Mars. So we wish all these persons God's blessing on their birthdays. Is there anybody at Mars who has a birthday and it's not in the parish? Is there anybody at Mars? Nobody at Mars? None of you at Mars? So we wish you a great birthday. Now, this morning, we have with us, as you in the parish letter, Precious Touch Foundation. And we are going to make a donation to the group. Let me explain to you and the members here. What we do in Lent, we ask members to make a sacrificial offering. And every day in Lent, we ask each member to set aside some money, and then we receive it, I think, Good Friday, Easter or so. And last year, we gave to 5 organizations some of what we receive, and we kept back a small portion for it. But the money that we get, at least for the last year this year, we don't use it to pay telephone bills or whatnot. We use it to give to the communities. And so this morning, your group was recommended as the group to receive our donation this year. So there's a difference. Last year we gave to 5 groups, but this year we decided we will give to 1 group. And by so doing, we will get a little more than if we give to 5 groups. But before we make the presentation, we're going to invite the president and the founder of the group, Ms. Adoria Maxwell Hazel, to address the parish, and then we will make the presentation.
Thank you. A very pleasant good morning, everyone. We are indeed honored, and we feel quite blessed this morning to be here worshiping with the congregation at St. Cyprian's Church. Now, I want to backtrack a little bit. I heard Reverend Canon Isaac spoke very lovingly about the foundation. I guess you all heard him. So he must have a love in his heart for the foundation and what we do. He spoke so well. He took everything from me. So I don't know what to say now. I just have to fill in the blanks. He said some very nice things about us. And one thing that I regret is that no one in our group at that time, I don't think, videotaped that. Did we get that? Did we get it? That would have been so nice, you know? Yeah. You know, to hear what he said, and we can take it to the rest and let the rest hear. You can do a playback? It is? Oh, how nice. No, we are more blessed. That's very good. What I will say before I go any further, let me just introduce my team, not by name, but ask them to stand and be recognized. That's my team there. Thank you. You may sit. Now, Precious Touch Foundation Inc. is a charitable, wish-granting children's organization, which was launched on November 24, 2007. What we do, we grant wishes to children between the age of 2 and 16 years old who are diagnosed with life-threatening medical conditions, conditions that threaten their life or put their lives in jeopardy. We step forward to bring a smile to these children's faces and create a magical, memorable, unforgettable experience in the lives of the children and by extension their families. These wishes are divided into four categories. So a child can wish to go somewhere, like maybe, Canada, New York, or any place in Barbados that they wish to go. They can wish to have something, and most of them like the electronic devices, the cell phones and the tablets and the computers and things like that. They can wish to be someone, if only for a day. Teacher, police officer, nurse, doctor, as we had before, or the fourth one, they can wish to meet. Even if a child wants to meet Canon Isaac, I think we can have that arranged in fine style. That's no problem. That can work. But that's what we do as a group. What we also do is that when the child reaches 16 years old and they have not yet gotten their wish from us, we don't just discard them. We don't just say, okay, you've reached 16 years old now, that's it. We hold the wish until the child's 18th birth date. Give them another chance to get the wish. Because for some reason, and mostly medical reasons, we are able to grant the wish at that time. So we would hold the wish a bit longer. The process is that there are forms to be completed by the parents or guardians. And then these forms are must be signed off by the doctor treating the child. The doctor must confirm or verify that the child is indeed diagnosed with a life-threatening medical condition and can therefore participate in our wish-granting program. So it's brought back to the committee, our board of directors, and we look at it, and we say, okay, this form looks good. We examine the form, it looks good. So then we call and make a house visit to see the child in the company of a parent, a guardian, or an adult. And we ask the child the three very important questions. We ask them to, give us three wishes from their heart. One, two, three. Putting the first one that they love most at the top. The reason why we do that is when we take the form back to our board of directors and we look at them, for instance, if the first one cannot be granted for some reason, and most of the time it's for medical reasons, then it is sad to have to tell the child, well, you can't have your first wish, we will go to the second wish, which is already here. Failing that, we go to the third wish. But we've never, St. Alban can attest to that, had to pass the first wish. We always try to get the first wish. Sometimes it has to be delayed. If it's a traveling wish, then we go back to the doctor and we said, this child wants to travel overseas on his or her wish. Is it possible? Is this a good wish for the child? And we might hear one of three things. Yes, it is. So then everybody's happy. Or it will be in a few weeks or months after the treatment is finished. So we put that aside and we wait. There's nothing we can do because we do not go outside of the doctor. What the doctor says, we don't go outside of that. We always stay within our boundaries. Or we might hear, that is not a very good wish for the child. Sorry, you have to go to wish number two. Sometimes we have to do that. And like I said, it's not a very nice thing having to tell a child that. But the parents do understand sometimes. We also make sure that when the wishes are finished, we don't just done away with our wish children. We stay with the families. We hear how they're doing. We follow up on the course of treatment. We follow up on their health. We take them out places. We have activities for them. And there are three main ones during the year. And it's our In April, we have what's called World Witch Day, which is celebrated worldwide among all witch granted organizations. So we have an activity for our children. We have our November celebrations. And I must add in here now that we celebrate 17 years on November 24th this year. We're growing up. We have a birthday on November 24th. And then at Christmas time in December, we have our big celebration where we go to on the pediatrics ward and we sing Christmas carols. And we have a very good choir. You should hear them sometimes. We give out presentation of gifts, which are usually donated to us. And we give refreshments. And we bring that year to a close. Now, with every wish that we get, we know our sponsors so well. We have some very dedicated and committed sponsors. So depending on the wish we get from the child, we know which sponsor to go to. That makes it so much easier for us. So we don't have time to, you know, say, okay, who do we go to or whatever. We know directly who would take this wish. And we try very, very hard not to have a lot of time elapse in between hearing a child's wish and granting the wish, because you never know what may happen next week or next month. So we try real hard to make these wishes come true as quickly as possible. Sadly, we have lost some of our wish children before the wishes were granted, some after wishes were granted. So that's why we work very, very quickly when we hear a wish. So we're always very, very appreciative, very grateful when individuals or churches, organizations give us a donation, because wishes do cost money. And the children are not concerned about where the money comes from. That's not my concern, that's yours. So we have to find the money, because we made a commitment and a promise to these children, you just tell us what you need and we will get it for you. So we can't go back on that. So we're very happy to be here this morning to receive a donation. I haven't received it in my hand yet, but I know that it's coming. So I'm going to say thanks very much on behalf of Precious Touch Foundation, Inc., the directors, members, volunteers, and by extension, our wish families. We thank you all very, very much. Now, to get a hold of Precious Touch, you can call 230-3402. Someone is sure to answer you, believe me. Or you can email us at info@preciouscouchfoundation.org. You can visit our Facebook or Instagram page. And if you visit the Facebook page, I'm going to ask you kindly to like the page and follow the Instagram page, because it helps us promote the work of the foundation. And that's what we need, the promotion to go far and wide. Or you can also see us on our website. So you have no difficulty in finding us. And I think at this stage, I will just quietly stop and stand at attention and wait for whatever is coming our way.
Most of the children are totally here.
Some of them are.
Thank you, Adoree, for those words. And just to reinforce, most of the children who play are totally here. And usually, I think the day sometimes before they get the age of 16 or so. So we are glad to make this presentation this morning. I got the check from the treasurer, and I suspect that after we give you this check, you will not need to pay anybody again for any donation. Is that so, Marley?
Wait,
so just. Right, so you don't have to beg again for any.
able to put it now? We thank you.
From last Sunday, we have two thank yous from persons. You know, last week we gave out 11 awards to people from Carrington Village, and some of them have sent back and said thank you. This is from Harriet Gill. And this is from Marilyn Race Boeing. So these are the two that we receive from it.
Our offertory hymn this morning is hymn 360. All creatures of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Hymn 360.
Thank you.
presentation of the offering. Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us. The blessing of the rogation elements. It is with a spirit of joy that we bring these elements before you for a blessing this day. We bring seed that will be sown into the earth, nourished by the richness of the soil and water that will enable the seed to grow into fullness. We give you thanks for the charge you have given us to be stewards of the earth. We give you thanks for the invitation you have given us to be co-creators with you, the one God who created all that exists. Creating God, you have given seed for the sower and bread to the people. Nourish, protect, and bless these seeds which your people will sow in hope. By your loving and bountiful giving, may they bring forth their fruit in due season through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Give of life, we give you thanks that in the richness of the soil, nature awakens by your call of spring. We praise you for the smell of freshly tilled earth, the beauty of a clean cut furrow and a well-plowed field. We ask you to help us to be good stewards of this land in the name of the one who gives us new life, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Sustaining God, we receive the fruit of the earth from you. We give you thanks for the smell of the earth after the rain, for its welcome cooling and its necessary hydration for the land. We ask that the rain come as often as it is needed, so that the crops may flourish and the coming harvest be indeed bountiful. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father Almighty, everlasting God. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who has sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed death. And by his rising to life again, he has won for us eternal life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and before the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord. Holy and gracious Father, all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, whom he sent to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. We therefore bring you these gifts. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who offered himself in obedience to your will, the perfect sacrifice for all mankind. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this
for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. When he gave thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. So, Father, calling to mind the death of your Son in joy for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension, his continued intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be favored with the Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May he make us a perpetual offering to you, enable us in communion with Blessed Mary, St. Cyprian, and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints with him and in him and through him. By the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. God of promise, you have prepared a banquet for us. Lamb of God, the gift of God for the people of God.
our first communion hymn, hymn 618, sent forth by God's blessing, our true faith confessing. Hymn 618, 618. Our next hymn is Showers of Blessing. There is the promise of love. There shall be showers of blessing.
Thank you.
Those who want to receive a blessing, do come up. The Lord be with you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us pray. Most merciful God, we thank you for feeding us. Into your holy church and for making us worthy to share of your saints in life. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you, your loved ones, this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Miss Angela Barrow, she also asked to say thank you to the parish for recognizing her last week as one of the persons from Carrington Village, Angela Barrow. I forgot to say a special welcome back to Lorraine Seeley, who was away for a few months. And we are glad to have you. And I miss you from church on Sunday. Glad to see you. And Lorraine also say on this day she wants to thank God. This is your 27th anniversary as one who had surgery for breast cancer 27 years ago today, and she thanked God for that day. The hymn, Standing on the Promises, Standing on the Promises.